All right, guys, so today I'm going to do a little modification to my PT01 Scratch. So I found this little voltage reader. I was tired of having to play the guessing game of where the charge was on my portable, you know, after using it for a certain amount of days or a week or whatever. You know, I just wanted to know exactly where my charge was as far as lifespan or percentage. So what this little guy right here does is it actually gives you a digital readout of the voltage. Not only that, it even gives you a little bar, a little power bar here that will change different colors when it's low or when it's fully charged. So I was trying to figure out the best spot to put it, and for me, I guess I'm gonna go right here. It's gonna be out of the way, and it'll give me a good visual indicator of where my charge is percentage wise. So anyway, let's get this going. So first off, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take out the 124C fader. So this is kind of a sneak peek for you guys, just to show you guys how easy it's going to be to install and uninstall the fader. So you take out one screw, take out screw number two, lift the fader up, unplug it from the bottom, and that's it. Let's set that to the side. Okay, let's flip this guy over. Goes off to the side. Okay. So let's open this up. Let's kind of gauge this out and see exactly where we're at, because you know, there's nothing major in here as far as what we can hit. I took the little USB port out of here. That's in the original one. So like I said, I think I'm gonna go about right in this area here, so there's really nothing to get in the way. But like I said, that's if you take the little USB port coming our board out of here that comes with your PT01 Scratch. I took everything out because I was like, I'm not gonna need it. So anyway, let's get to drilling here. Screws fell out. Okay, so I think I'm gonna go about right here, somewhat in the middle, I suppose. And this right here is called a step drill bit. So let's start drilling here. I guess I'm just gonna kind of eye it. So you definitely want to make sure, you know, before you start drilling, that there's nothing that you're going to hit underneath that's valuable. And I should have brought it down just a little bit, because it looks like I'm actually going to get, I'm gonna hit some stuff here. So I maybe should have brought it down just a little bit more, but it's too late now. Gotta keep on going. Long way to go. Drilling any wires or anything like that. That looks, we're close. Maybe just a tad bit more. I'm gonna try to come up from the bottom as well. So you guys might be able to see that, but yeah, see how I kind of whoopsed it up a little bit there. I'm pretty close to that battery compartment, but that's still nothing important there. It's just plastic, so we'll be all right. Whoa. Like I said, I'm most likely gonna have to cut some of this plastic out down here too, but that's okay. Dang, there you go. I forgot how messy this stuff gets. Anyway, so check it out. Man, that might actually clear. Might have to go just a tad bit more, just so that this sits a little flush. But man, that actually is gonna look really cool when it's done. Just a little high, so let's take a little bit more off. Not too much, though. Ooh. So, check it out. Boom. That's where that's gonna be, right there. And you're gonna take your little ring here on the bottom. All right, guys, so I did decide to cut out the plastic around that because I really do wanna use this little tightening bolt, plastic nut, whatever, to keep the volt meter in place. I didn't really want to hot glue it in place, so like I said, I'm not going to half-ass it. I'm going to do it the right way. So what I did is I used some of these industrial scissors like this and cut out most of the plastic, but now I need to smooth out the rest of the plastic that I couldn't get, so I'm going to use this Dremel tool here, and I'm just going to smooth out the rest of the plastic so I get a nice flat surface. So this will tighten down as best as possible, so let's see what happens. So I don't know if you're going to be able to see this, but right here, so I cut all this plastic out, cut this out, cut some plastic off of here, but if you can see right here, it's really, it's not smooth. There's a lot of broken plastic here still that I need to smooth that out. There we go. That's a lot better. So now it's a lot smoother there. So this will now fit flush. Let's try it. Let's see, now I got enough space in here to put that little plastic tightening ring or nut or whatever you want to call it. Go. See, now it's nice and tight. ain't gonna go nowhere. So, as you can see, nice and tight in there. I'm gonna loosen this up because it's not straight. I want it to be straighter. But anyway, you get the idea. So, now all we gotta do is run our wire, a power wire. Set. Man, I tightened down pretty good actually. There it is. So boom, that's what that's gonna look like right there. And like I said, I gotta clean all this old sticker residue off. But that's that for now. So now we gotta do is just run some power. And I'm trying to figure out the best place to tap off for power. I might not even use these wires. I might just go with some thinner gauge wire that I can run and give me a little more play. So when I open this up, it's, you know, see how much extra wire I have just in case I have to open it up. I can open it and fold it open. So that's probably what I'm gonna do next.
Guys, so what I did to get power is I ran previously, I had 12 volts going to this little relay here for the start stop button, so I decided to just tie directly into this just to make it a little easier for me, and then I'm running that wire all the way up to the little volt meter. So let's flip it over and see what happens. I'm about to turn this on. There you go. 11.7, so this definitely needs to be charged up. But now, it's no more guessing. Now I'll know for sure. So hopefully these videos helped you out, and if you decide to do it, I can put the link in the description of where I actually got this little meter. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Peace.